what it is, what it does, what it is, what it isn't. Looking for a better way to get up out of bed instead of getting on the internet and checking a new hit. Me get up, fresh shot, come strut walking. A little bit of humble, a little bit of cautious. Somewhere between like Rocky and Cosby, for the game. Nope, nope, y'all can't copy.
I'm next to Yahoo from Botswana. So,
With Citra. She's from the oldest civilization, that is Iraq. So Citra, I saw your performance. It was completely different from others. Others were singing, dancing, and like doing strange things. But you came actually with a video showing images of your country, Iraq. So what was the purpose of this video?
Actually, hi, I'm Citra from Iraq. Thank you for the interview. First, actually, I was planning to do a dance. But because the situation in Iraq is not stable now, and a lot of people are dying, especially in my city. So we decided not to do the dance, and I'm going to recite a poem and show the video. The main purpose of the video is to show my civilization, the Iraq in another way, that the TV and all the media are showing Iraq. They are only showing people are dying, killing, lost, and a destroyed city. But actually Iraq is a wonderful country. There are a lot of places which you can visit. And the oldest civilization in the world. And as you see, as in the north of Iraq, there is a lot of waterfalls, natural resources, and now it's more developed, like in Erbil, Sulaymaniyah. Also in Mosul, there is a lot of ancient places you can visit, in Samarra, Hejaz, Karbala, Al-Basra, all those.
So in conclusion, Iraq is one of the most hidden countries with beautiful talent and culture. And just a simple tip is that Iraq, as I said earlier, is one of the eldest civilizations.
Adeline, she's from Malaysia. So tell me, Adeline, since you're local, what did you think about what you saw of this international cultural show?
Event was rich in culture, in colors, the food was really nice. So I hope that you will see everything through this video. So, au revoir.
For giving me the permission to come to the National Cultural Night. So actually once there, what attracted me the most was the noise. Trust me, from outside you could hear people shouting, like the excitement was here, and once inside it was worse. Everyone was encouraging the performers, everyone was standing, dancing, that even it was so hard for us to record when during the interviews, even from outside, you couldn't hear anything. I saw so many performers, like Botswana, I never saw them performing before. I even saw Yemen, I even saw my very first Iraqi. So I talked to her through the interview and also as well after. So she told me like so many things about her country, and then there's around 10,000 Iraqi in Malaysia, so I was really surprised because 10,000 is quite a lot. So after that, I also interviewed the event organizers. Both of them are from Indonesia. So I also have a few questions, but due to background noise, I couldn't include their interview in this video. So just to summarize, what they told me is they were expecting 500 people, but based on their registration, they got more than 500. So I was like, 500, this is really a lot. So it means there were a lot of work behind. And then they also told me like the theme was mosaic, as you could see earlier in this video. So I was like, but why mosaic? So that was just simple actually. Mosaic is just like a collage of many cultures together to bring into one event. And this could be seen. So actually, that's all. So I hope I'm going to see you next week, Wednesday as usual. So stay tuned on A Minute with Claire.
My posse's been on Broadway, and we did it all way. Chrome music, I shed my skin and put my bones into everything I record to it. And yeah, I'm on. Let that stage light go and shine on down. Got that Bob Barker suit game and Plinko in my style. Money, stay on my craft and stick around for those pounds. But I do that to pass the torch and put